Alrighty then. Welcome back. We're on to the next project. The first one, the last project, I should say, was the entry table. It's functional, running. We're on to the next project, decent sized one. And I forgot to film an intro for this video, so this is a little later on, and right behind me is the actual project itself. We're building a plate roller today. The goal is 4 foot wide, which we'll get that, but the goal is to run at least 14 gauge through it, be able to roll 14 gauge by 4 foot wide. This is in preparation. I need that to build the next project, which is the big one. Let's jump back in time to the beginning, get this project going.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Hey, look at that. That's hot. not thoroughly disappointed with that. Idler.
In there.
I spared you all the building of this. It's a handle, drive gear. This whole thing will be flipped around backwards when I decide to turn this into a driven roller. But for now, I've got it this way. That's why I got all this crap on it. Spacers so that it lines up. Alright, so quick rundown on this thing and everything it does. Obviously, you got the drive, you saw that, crank the handle, it goes. We got this, hard to see, but that ratchet handle I built, that controls the crowd roll, lifts this thing up and down. I got the tensioner and everything you saw in there. This is what gets in the way and makes the plate bend. That's why it's a number 50 chain, because I actually will probably be using that sometimes under pressure. So the plate will be in there and I'll need to ratchet it down. So I need to strengthen that. The other chain and the hand wheel here, this is for raising this roll up and down. This is the pinch roll to adjust for the thickness. Then you can tighten it down on there. That's really it. I got this head. This is what folds down to get a full roll off, full piece off of it that you can't take off. Otherwise, I got my snubber bar and the snubber down here. Those of you who don't know what snubber is, I don't even know if that's what it's called. I just found another video and that's what they called it. When you're rolling a cone, you need something to stop it from just rolling that disc straight through. So you put that cone in there and it rubs against the side of that and helps rotate that piece through that donut. So that's that, and it actually kind of helps with trying to roll stuff straight too. If you got something in there a little cockeyed, butt that up against it and start rolling and it'll twist it straight. One thing about rolling cones is you got to tilt one of your rolls so that it pinches the inside of the cone and allows the outside to move through faster. Well, to do that, that's what this handle comes, this where this handle comes in. I can back it down like this until the nut head is exposed. Okay, now this end is no longer engaged with the chain. I turn that end wheel, this end of the roll is gonna go up or down based on how I turn that, and this one's gonna stay still. Once I get it where I want it, cockeyed, I can run that thing back up in there, tighten it up tight, and now the whole roll will move at that angle. Cone. Well, it's a little funky. First cone roll ever. It's gonna take me a bit to figure out the ins and outs of that business. The thing is, I need this for this project I'm working on, so I'm gonna have to, I think I can get it pressed into place. Looks like it didn't roll the inside enough, rolled the outside too much, so the angle wasn't enough. I don't know, we'll see. I'm not disappointed though. Good start.